Live from the studios of Channel 4 in Oklahoma City.
Harry Campbell's
greetings.
Oh, Chris Danielson.
Take a look at this crowd, because this crowd is the foundation of what this television station is today. A big round of applause for all of you. We have a family of apps that keeps your family safe. Our family's here to keep your family. Okay, we're always doing promos. So these are the folks that lead and direct and make Channel 4 KFOR-TV. Starting out as WKY Television in 1949, you have led the way with many significant firsts, including broadcasting the first tornado warning in 1954 and hiring the first female TV reporter in 1972.
Google News Channel 4. Google it on any computer anywhere in the world. And the first station to come up is News Channel 4, as in KFOR, News Channel 4, Oklahoma City. Not News Channel 4 in New York City, not News Channel 4 in Los Angeles. We're talking Oklahoma City. You see, there's a reason the world's most powerful search engine is first to recognize KFOR News Channel 4. And it all started 65 years ago. On June 6th, 1949, broadcast history was made in Oklahoma when WKY-TV Channel 4 signed on.
You know that you get more by watching Channel 4, and the reason is easy to see. When you are watching WKY Personality TV.
The visionary behind the station was Edward K. Gaylord, owner of Oklahoma Publishing and owner of WKY Radio. The WKY TV studios were in the Municipal Auditorium in downtown Oklahoma City. And until 1953, WKY TV was the only TV station in Oklahoma City. WKY-TV was a station of firsts. It was one of the first TV stations to begin broadcasting in color in 1954, years before other stations across the country.
The following program comes to you in living color.
And now a word from our sponsor.
The legend among shoe tanners that one of the reasons that the rump area of the hide of the horse differs in substance, texture, and density than the rest of the hide, it's because horses for centuries have always stood with their rears exposed to the elements. The makers of Kohlhan shoes use this leather with its distinctive tannage. They use this for casual footwear, like this hand-sewn Norwegian slip-on or this hand-sewn half-chucker. And by their rugged outdoor appearance, just one look and you'll know they are Kohlhan. From Rothschild's Varsity Shop, downtown, uptown, Penn Square.
We had two tornado alerts this afternoon.
In September 1954, meteorologist Harry Volkman issued the first live on-air tornado warning to viewers.
Another of our vital news services here at WKY Television is our weather department.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Wally Kanan, WKY TV staff meteorologist, and there on the board I've drawn our graphic representation of a tornado funnel, one of the most dreaded phenomenon, and indeed one of the most severe in all of weather.
It used to be illegal to do so, but management believed that issuing the warning would save lives, and it did. In good times and in bad, Channel 4's popularity grew. Every home had at least one TV set. WKY-TV knew the future of running a successful TV station meant producing good local programming.
My name is Ernie Schultz, and I came to work at Channel 4 in 1955 and left in 1980. We were always right out in front, and it was very exciting. First black and white film, then color film, color studio cameras. The way the technology developed, live cameras, that kind of thing, and we had an enormously talented group in the information programming area. They were state-of-the-art people. that all work together to create a new medium.
There were hugely successful children's shows like 3D Danny.
Hey, Unicorman, how are you today? My name is Dan D. Dynamo, Superintendent of the Space Science Center and Supreme Galaxy Chief of the Universe Science Corps. I salute you.
Foreman Scotty.
Well, I want to get battle. I want both of you out there with those hand mowers. I want you to mow that grass like I told you in the first place. In tarnation was that.
And the Buck Owens Ranch Show was syndicated in more than 100 TV markets.
Hi, everybody. My name is Buck Owens, and welcome to our show.
Channel 4 became part of your family, your lives, your memories. Celebrities, movie stars, politicians all flocked to Oklahoma City to be on Channel 4. The station was a magnet for talent and innovation. Viewers were drawn to broadcasting legends Jack Ogle, Bob Barry Sr., Danny Williams, and Linda Cavanaugh. She's celebrating more than 37 years on the air.
The Scene, a montage of America's top music makers. Today's special guest is
the Guess Who.
And now here's your host, Ronnie Kaye.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hello, everybody. This is a fantastic foot stomper of gigantic proportions to open our show today. The Scene decorates the set with paper lace and a song called The Night Chicago Died.
Daddy was a cop on the east side of Chicago, back in the USA, back in the bad old days. In the heat of a summer night, dollar bill, when the town of Chicago died, and they talk about it still.
And now a word from our sponsor.
At Mathis Brothers Furniture, we always have from 80 to 100 different living room settings to choose from.
And during the anniversary sale, one-third to one-half of the living room groupings must be closed out to make room for new arrivals. Some living room furniture will sell at one-half the regular price.
Look at this nylon velvet sofa and love seat made by Bassett, originally $900, now only $499.
Or look at this Stratford Herculon velvet sofa and love seat. It was $1,000, now it's only $599 during the anniversary sale at Mathis Brothers Furniture, 3434 West Reno.
Channel 4 in Oklahoma City, it's 10 o'clock. Do you know where your children are?
From Oklahoma's first television station, this is News Center 4 Update.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Brad Edwards. Linda Cavanaugh is off tonight celebrating somewhere.
The quality and reputation of our news and weather grew, winning awards locally, regionally, and nationally. And our station remains one of the strongest NBC affiliates in the country.
I started to work at WKY-TV September the 16th, 1968. And Ernie made the announcement at, in the meeting that we're going to start a special creative service department, but Bob Dotson will be in charge of it. And the first thing you're going to do, we're going to do a Black History story on all of them. It ended up winning several awards, national awards, but the one that we're most proud of is it won the National Emmy Award.
Hi, Bob Dotson here with Oklahoma's first Emmy for a program called The People Through the Looking Glass Darkly. It helped Channel 4 celebrate its silver anniversary and sent me looking for American stories.
The only constant in TV is change. In 1976, WKY-TV was sold to Detroit-based Evening News Association, and Channel 4's call letters were changed to KTVY.
It's a new four, bring you more than ever before. A friendly knock there on your door. Oh, okay, see, it's a new four. A spirit's high, we're proud to be bringing the world home for you to see.
In the late 1980s, KTVY was the first station in the country to introduce color Doppler radar.
This is a cloud. It can make severe weather. This is radar. It sends out a beam looking for severe weather. Radar can't see what's directly above it. Sometimes severe weather clouds like to hide there. This is Oklahoma City. Weather radar located there has difficulty detecting severe weather in the metropolitan area. Only one television station has its radar located outside of Oklahoma City, so it can track severe storms within the Oklahoma City area. News 4 Oklahoma. We're wired for weather.
The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
First in Oklahoma 35 years ago, and now, more than ever, four's the walk.
We're for Oklahoma. We've had 30 wonderful years. We've had 30 marvelous seasons. The reasons are clear. 'Cause you are Oklahoma. And you've been with us all the way. For 30 wonderful years.
The legacy started before I got here with a lot of talented people, not only on the air, but management and behind the scenes. But I think we knew one thing, that we had something special because we had special people. And that's what makes your station. That's your talent, of course. And you build around the newsroom and the sports and your weather. But we had a lot of camaraderie and everybody loved coming to work.
Watching Oklahoma's News Channel 4.
In 1990, the call letters changed again, this time to KFOR-TV. The New York Times purchased KFOR-TV in 1996. In the late 90s, KFOR pioneered the use of pictures and photos over cell phones.
When there's bad weather, see it first with First Video.
It's revolutionary technology right over your car phone. Unbelievable.
Technology that lets forewarned units send moving video over their cellular phones. That means you see immediate storm video from anywhere in the state.
Folks, I want to show you, that's video over a cellular phone.
See it first. First Video with Mike Morgan and the Forewarn Weather Team on News Channel 4, where the news and weather come first, 24 hours a day.
In April of 1995, the bombing of the Murrah Building was devastating.
Many of us here in the city felt it, heard it, were all a part of it as our community tries to recover from this terrible tragedy.
Take a look for yourself. There's the Alfred Murray Federal Building behind me, and you can see just how badly damaged it is.
But out of that immense tragedy, the resilient spirit of Oklahomans shined on.
Working on Tapestry for the Oklahoma City bombing was likewise an eye-opening, compelling experience, because you saw Oklahomans who were your neighbor who suddenly have become victims, and their reaction to what happened on that April morning really defined Oklahoma in so many respects, but it also defined my understanding of what courage was and what compassion could be. Because these were people who one day had a family and they'd just gone to work, and all of a sudden they had lost family members, or their lives had been changed through their injuries. And to follow them through that year period after the bombing was to see people cope with things that oftentimes they thought they would never have been able to cope with, and they did.
A beautiful memorial was built, and each year in April, News Channel 4 carries the OKC Memorial Marathon.
Fast forward to 2014 and Channel 4 continues to dominate on the weather front.
In Oklahoma, our weather's tough, but our people are tougher. And the Forewarned Storm Team is the weather team Oklahomans rely on most. Stay forewarned and keep watching News Channel 4.
Download Forewarn Me, absolutely the best free severe weather app in Oklahoma. Watch Forewarn weather coverage from your smartphone. Go to KFOR.com/appcenter. In May of 2007, the New York Times Company finalized the sale of both KFOR-TV and KAUT-TV to Local TV LLC. And in December of 2013, Tribune Broadcasting finalized the purchase of KFOR and KAUT from Local TV for more than $2.7 billion. 65 years, hundreds of thousands of stories, and millions of memories. KFOR News Channel 4 is the one station more Oklahomans turn to most. On air, online, on your smartphone. We've been there to chronicle the ups and the downs. We've seen dreams come true and lives changed forever. That was then. This is now. And now a word from our future sponsor.
Howdy, friends, folks, and other alien life forms, both silicon and carbon-based. Ricky Rocket here with Intergalactic Spaceship Sales and Services with the greatest deals this side of the galaxy. Come in and test, launch, and fly any of our new Ion Pulse Hyperdrive models. And check this out. The newest in asteroid avoidance collision systems. Whoa, talk about cosmetically cool, and if you come in today, we'll throw in a free cryo chamber for those long interstellar flights to visit your monster-in-law. Oh, I mean mother-in-law. Oh, we're gonna get calls about that one. If you want a good deal on a rockamobile, call Ricky Rocket. Ricky Rocket, located on the third ring of Saturn, right next to the OnQ Cosmetic Collision Service. If you've reached Uranus, you've gone too far. What? It's true! Ricky Rockets is a proud sponsor of News Channel 4000. Hey, Linda, still looking good.
Thanks, Ricky Rocket.
KFOR News Channel 4 is moving forward, leading the way into the future. On a big screen or a small one, viewers turn to KFOR News Channel 4, looking for help, looking for answers, looking for information they want, when they want it. If you Google KFOR News Channel 4, you'll learn one important lesson. We're always there. Always there for you. KFOR News Channel 4. Then, now, and moving forward.
All of us at the Today Show wish Channel 4 a happy 65th.
Happy 65th anniversary, Channel 4.
Happy 65th anniversary, Channel 4, Boomer Sooner.
Happy 65th anniversary, News Channel 4. You're looking good.
Hi, I'm Nadia Komunich. Congratulations on your 65th anniversary, Channel 4. You deserve a perfect 10.
Hi, Bob Toy here. 65 is a good score in golf. It's also a good anniversary. Congratulations, Channel 4.
Happy 65th anniversary, Channel 4, from a 65-year-old golfer. Hey, wait a minute, I'm 37.
Happy 65th anniversary to Channel 4. You're looking good.
Congratulations on your 65th anniversary at News Channel 4.
Hey, y'all, I'm Cowboy Troy. You might remember me from hit songs like I Play Chicken with the Train, or you might know my new music, songs like Giddy Up. Either way, I'd like to say congratulations, Channel 4, on an outstanding 65 years.
Hi, I'm Olympic gymnast Bart Connor, and I'm so excited about Channel 4's 65th anniversary that, of course, I feel compelled to do a Bart wheel. Ta-da!
I'm Serge Baca of the Oklahoma City Thunder. Happy 65th anniversary, Channel 4.
KFOR, 65 years of being the news leader in Oklahoma. You are the person. I'm not going to say the man, because that's not politically correct, but you are the one When Oklahomans need their news, when they need their weather, when they need to know, they have turned to you for 65 years. Here's to another 65. Who knows where we're going to be? What will we be doing? In fact, people will probably be watching you right here on the insides of your eyes. We won't even have TVs. We'll be walking around going, man, that News Channel 4, that's fantastic. Hey, look at that. Hold on. I've got an email coming in.
Hi, I'm Corey Ayers, the moving image archivist here at the Oklahoma Historical Society. Happy 65th anniversary, Channel 4. Some of the video you just saw on this Channel 4 presentation was transferred from old film to video in this very room. Channel 4 donated over 8,000 individual film reels of footage to the Oklahoma Historical Society, and we've launched a 6-year initiative with Channel 4 to get all of it dubbed to high-resolution video files.
I don't know if this is a homecoming or my final Golden Way party. You know, seeing the you people out here, and particularly the ones that are currently working here.
Can I say three words?
Go right ahead.
We love folks. A little over 60 years ago, Jude and Jody came out here under Mr. Smith. And guess what? I was wearing this suit. I see a lot of familiar faces. Some of the young folks don't remember us. I'm 82 years old. Yes, sir. I'm shooting for 90. But anyway, thank you very much. And I hope to see you maybe on the news or something. These guys are taking, you taking my picture? No. Marilyn Monroe.
You get more by watching Channel 4, and the reason is easy to see. On WKY, Personality TV.
Coming back on the 65th, how great is it to see how far the station has come?
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I haven't been to Oklahoma in a while, so it was just, you know, part of it I remember, but then part of it's so new, and it's just a kind of an overwhelming experience because I feel like I'm in a time warp. You know, I feel like I'm part of a Hollywood movie or something. You know, I'm going back in time.
But no, it's great memories. You see these halls, and you remember the hundreds of fine, wonderful people that walked these halls and provided service to our community.
I was here during the best time of television, I think. It's a lot simpler and not, we progressed a lot over the period of years. Things changed technically, and I guess you could say physically we changed from our weather board to a computer. That was an upgrade, and they just went from there. No telling what it's going to be like in 10 more years.